haven't posted anything on YouTube for a while now, but I'm back. I just started a new job not too long ago, so that has been taking up my time. But now I have a couple of days off work because of the coronavirus, so I'm gonna have a lot of time to really catch up with painting, and that's what I'm gonna do for the next couple of days. And I thought it would be a perfect time to make some time lapses for you to see, and yeah, I'm gonna do that in this little vlog, and I hope you will enjoy it.
Thank you.
So the tea of the day is a South Korean tea, a green one, and the cup of the day is this cute little one inspired by Japanese design, and I will leave the Etsy shop down below if you want to check it out. I know this day hasn't been that exciting, I've just been painting this painting all day, but it's taking so long. And I'm not really used to painting with oils, but I am practicing, and that's also why I choose to, for the time being, paint in a very realistic style. I like to make very realistic pieces of art in the beginning when I'm trying to get used to a new medium. So when I started making art, I only drew with a normal graphic pencils, and I made these very realistic, like almost photorealistic portraits with a pencil, and now I'm trying out oils. I have made one oil painting that was not in a very realistic style of Aphrodite, and I want to make an entire series out of that painting, where I will paint some more paintings in. There will be about, what's it called, mythology, and I want to paint like different mythological, what's it called, like creatures or gods or people, and she will represent the Greek mythology, and I don't know which one I will make next, but maybe I will include that in this vlog if I come around to making one of those in the next couple of days. But that's a more loose style, and it's a lot quicker. This definitely takes a long time to finish, but I really like it, and I think she's turning out really cute. I'm currently reading this book, The Artist Way by Julia Cameron, and it's kind of like a 12-week creativity course, and there are different tasks you can do to get more creative, and it is really, I've seen it recommended so many times, so now I thought that I would try it out. And one of the things you should do every day, according to this book, is write 3 morning pages every morning, where you just jot down all of your thoughts. It doesn't matter what you write, you just get your thoughts down on paper. And it's supposed to like clear your mind and kind of like a declutter, I think. So that there will be more space in your mind to be creative. I don't really understand, but this is the first day I am trying it, and yeah, it took a long time actually. So yeah, but I'll give it a try, and yeah, let's see. I think I'll paint another layer on these nun and monk paintings I'm working on right now for a gallery show, and then I also have to buy some more paper today at the art store, and let's see what else I'm going to paint today. Thank you. Hi guys, I am back from the art supply store and the grocery store, and well, I got what I needed, but I didn't go very well. When I had just bought my large sheets of paper and my wooden boards for painting, it just started pouring down, and my paper was only wrapped in this paper. And then I had these large boards that I also had to bring home, and everything is just so wet now. Fortunately, this paper managed to keep my sheets dry. It's not too wet inside here, so that's nice, but it was just so difficult to balance everything on my bike. I both had the groceries, and I had all of this, and yeah, I only had my bike, and I had to, I couldn't ride my bike, so I had to pull it, and it was just awful, so wet. And now look at this pretty, pretty blue sky, and it's just the best weather. And it also looked like this when I went out, and that's also why I went out, because yesterday it was just pouring down all day long. But yeah, that's just Danish weather for you. Woohoo! Okay, I thought I'd just continue painting on this one to just relax a little bit before I start putting gesso on the wooden boards I bought and sketching on the paper. So I just wanted to show you my new desk area, because I had my dad make this for me, and I love it. I think it's so cute and pretty. I have my easel over here, my palette, my paint tubes and brushes, and then I have this lovely print by my friend Louise, and I will link her Instagram down below if you want to check her out. I think it's so cute. And then I have some plants and a little cactus in this really, really cute ceramics pot I bought at a design market that I actually attended myself with a little, what's it called, stall. And yeah, I think I absolutely love this. And then I also have this plant pot I got for my birthday, but I don't have a plant for it yet. This one I found, this little drawer thing, I found on the street, and it's perfectly fine, and I can put art supplies in here and paper up here, and then I have some more plants and a little cactus. Yeah, and then I just have my tea right here always, and I can have my music going on my computer and look at my reference photo. Yeah, it's perfect. We'll be right back. need to water my plants and then I will start painting. Okay, I finally found out what I want to paint today. I am going to paint another painting for my series of mythology. And the god I'm going to paint today is Freya from Norse mythology. I'll be sipping my tea while I draw Freya on my new gesso board.
This painting will be a part of my mythology series, and this painting will represent Norse mythology, which is the mythology of my ancestors. This is the goddess Freya. Maybe you have heard of her, or maybe you have heard of some of the more well-known gods like Odin or Thor with the hammer Mjolnir, which he uses to make thunder. But Freya is the goddess of love, sex, lust, beauty, fertility, sorcery, gold, war, and death. She is incredibly beautiful and has many admirers. Freya loves to travel, and she would sometimes take a ride in her chariot pulled by two black or grey cats. But she was also able to fly by using her cloak of falcon feathers. I will paint her here with a strong look in her eyes and a strong jawline too, but also with a very seductive mouth, which is inspired by Dante Rossetti's paintings of Alexa Wilding. She's going to have a feather cloak and braids, because I think that's very Scandinavian and Viking-like. This technique you're seeing me use here is much faster, and I'm not too concerned with details or blending. I have mixed a lot of colors here on my palette, and now I'm just applying them very loosely with my brush. I really like this style. It looks both old-fashioned and also a little contemporary at the same time to me. So. Yeah, I'll keep painting and I'll talk to you later. Bye.
morning, it's a new day. Oh, actually it's not morning anymore. Well, I just sketched out this little girl I met in Nepal for another series of paintings I'm working on right now of women from Nepal. That will be a part of a gallery show I have next year in Sweden. Yeah, but I just wanted to sketch this out before I will paint it tomorrow, I think. I don't think I'll have time for it today, so I might just do it tomorrow. But I'm quite anxious about starting this painting because it's so big, and I have never made any watercolor paintings this big before. I'm just gonna finish the oil painting that I started yesterday now, so I can have that done. Yeah, let's go. Thank you so much for making it to the very last bit of this video. I made this Nepali girl painting on Monday and Tuesday, and it was quite different to paint a very large watercolor painting. I'm not used to that, so in the beginning I had laid her down on the floor and started painting like that because I like to paint in very wet layers, so if I were to put her up on my easel it would just drip too much. But I like the kind of marble effect you can get when you paint in very wet layers. But when I finally put her up on the easel, I noticed that I had made her eyes completely weird. They were looking in two different directions and I had to fix that, but I think I succeeded with that. So, and in the end I was actually really happy with how the painting turned out, and yeah, I really like the colors also, how they look together, and I hope you like it too. Please let me know if you have any comments about some of the art or this video in general. I would love to know, and subscribe if you like, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!
the shame.